With the help of my good pal Caveman Films, we're going to completely change your perceptions of what Minecraft can really do. Oh yeah, this is gonna be fun. Hey, what you got there?
I'm playing some Minecraft, so I wanted to grab a Soylent.
Why Soylent, though?
Well, my body craves some good nutrients, and I'm strapped for time, so let's go!
I spend so much time in Minecraft...
Hello everyone, the Forest here. That clip before was an actual fucking ad from Ant Venom for Soylent. I'm not even fucking kidding, that was an actual ad from this video right here. And it's really fucking funny, man. It's really fucking funny. But that's not the main topic of this video. It is definitely not the main topic of this video. I'm talking about pipelines. Online pipelines. The first one that most people think of when they think of pipelines is the pipeline to the alt-right. To the alt-right or some bullshit like that, you know? You know, and it's always that. It's never like, I'm not even saying this, you know, to like, to be some kind of like weird persons and like say, oh, but they do this, but they do this for that, but no one ever does that for this, you know, some bullshit like that. But I'm just saying, there's never ever said of a pipeline to, you know, being a fucking retard, which is following bread. Bread tube is, I think, kind of not doing too good right now. I think I don't fucking know, you know, the main headers on that. Nah, I'm a retard, but I was about to say Bosch, but I know nothing about that shit because I'm not into that shit. I am not weird, all right. But anyways, pipelines. Okay, also, I need to say this too before I go get into any further. The fucking thumbnail is like that because I was bored. I was genuinely bored, and I was thinking, wouldn't it be funny just to make it look fucking complex as fuck, you know, having pipe systems overlapping one another, having text on that shit, you know, all that shit. I'm not actually crazy, I'm not actually, you know, schizophrenic or some unhinged bullshit that's going on in my mind, nothing like that. I am nothing like that. But anyways, pipelines to ideologies online. Do you know what's the easiest way to not get into a pipeline? It's to just kind of, you know, close your computer. Just close your computer, or just, I don't know, maybe not, actually, no. Because I have to be careful with what I say in this video, or else I get called, like, every ist phobe under the sun, and I hate saying that because it makes me sound like one of those, I'll fucking kill myself if I say one more time. Like, because it makes me sound like one of those gay, right-wing, fucking people. Not the ones that are actually right-wing, but more over so the ones that are, you know, kind of like planted opposition, you know, some bullshit like that, you know? That acts like one, but isn't actually one, you know? You know that guy, Christian Rocker, that fucking gay, black, like, Christian conservative, like, you, that's a contradiction in so many ways. Holy shit, what are you, I'm not even gonna get deep into that, but that's just a contradiction. What the fuck? Now I'm noticing that. But anyways, the pipelines, I'm sorry if I just, you know, dilly dally on that shit, but the pipelines to whatever type of bullshit that these people like to say, people still genuinely think to this day, after almost 5 years after it happened, you know, when PewDiePie, when PewDiePie made some edgy jokes and said the hard R on stream and all that shit, when it was on accident and all that stuff, they genuinely still think, because of some cocksuckers at the Washington Post, I think that's the name, the Huffington Post, and then like some other cocksucker publications made Felix look like an actual, you know, bad person and all that shit. And other and, like, people still genuinely believe that he is like, oh my god, he's the pipeline to the alt-right, or like all these other people who were in their prime in 2016, like Filthy Frank, iDubbbz, fucking H3H3, which I you know, those publications affected H3H3. I don't think for iDubbbz it affected him that much. Filthy Frank went out before any of that bullshit happened. But H3H3 got that to his head, and also Anthony Fantano, because he's a bit too edgy, and someone put his picture as this like shooter who shot up like a college or some shit like that, because they look so fucking similar, and so he distances himself away from that shit. If that shit ever happens to me, bro, I don't really care. Like, I don't really care. If it's in a different state, I don't really care. If in the same state, okay, I might be a bit worried, but I don't give a like, I will sue them, or not sue the person, that'd be gay, but sue, like, the news station who did that shit, you know? I'm like, what the fuck? Why are you making me look like a fucking school shooter? You know? The blah, blah, blah type bullshit, you know? Why are you making me look like that, you know? Fuck you. Bitch, but anyways, those two people, Anthony Fantano and H3H3, which coincidentally are the most insufferable ass motherfuckers, they are the victims to the pipelines of being a fucking retard. That is what the other pipeline is, the main other pipeline, and that goes for in general of other people, you know, content creators who become so overly political in such a short amount of time, or like not in a short amount of time, but more of so like in the gradual amount of time, when like event A happens, they get their take in a kind of like a small dick kind of way, you know, small dick energy type of shit, then they gradually progressively overload on that bullshit until it hits like this boiling point when they get this 100,000 like tweet, probably ratioing some fucking government official or just saying what they did is bad, just some simple shit like that, some simple shit like that. And I'm probably saying the majority, like what the majority of people who know what I'm talking about, what they think in their mind, it's always the things, it's always the explicitly obscure shit that everybody knows. That's the explicit part, but it's obscure in the ways of people who talk about it, in the way of articulation of how people do it and how many people actually talk about it, you know? I think I repeated that point twice, but it is worth emphasizing. I actually sound very pretentious in this recording. I don't give a fuck. I'm sorry, but I'm not gonna pretend I don't care, because there's two levels of care. There's actual genuine care, you know, for your reputation and all your bullshit, you know, your money and all that shit. But there's the care of this, like the surface level care that you just don't care what people think of you. People like what people say or think of you, what you do or say, you know, speak your mind and all that shit, you know. And there's a lot of other people who fall into that pipeline of being a fucking retard. I do mean that by as in general. As in general, it isn't like it is a sort of a coincidence that both Anthony and Ethan are both, you know, like, are both, you know, left-leaning and all that shit, you know, it is a coincidence, but they're both retarded at the same time. Some other people did, but from other affiliations and shit like that. And there was some other retarded shit that is happening right now with Sneeko and Andrew Tate. Andrew Tate's blowing up Sneeko's blowing up. Do you want to know how I found Sneeko? I found Sneeko through the Hamza beef. Through Hamza. I'm not even fucking kidding. I found Sneeko funny. Not like, I know people are gonna like think in their mind like, oh, of course this guy thinks he's funny. Of course, just look at him. I know they don't talk like that, but their mental voice probably sounds like that in different variations. Probably higher due to the higher estrogen, you know, all that bullshit. The estrogenic, or however you say it, the feminine energy that they're having, even though they're kind of like, you know, a dude and all that stuff. Oh my god, you know, that's bad what you said. Okay. Alright. But I know people are gonna think I'm in some like, oh, you're in some deep end or some shit like that. You must believe what Nick Fuentes says. I don't give a fuck what Nick Fuentes says. He's a fucking cat boy extraordinaire. That might make some people or followers of him like him more, some shit like that, which I think is weird. I know I never even liked him, not as in like a, oh, I don't like this person because he's bad. No, I just don't know him that much. All I know was from two clips of him saying like, oh, POV, you're a woman, and he just punches the fucking camera slowly, obviously. And there was another one where I can say like everything but the last thing where he says you're cringe. It's like something, you're cringe, you're this, you're that, and you're not even funny, and like, you know, some shit like that. That clip and the other clip, that's it. I only know him through that, and also of his, you know, affiliations and shit like that too. But for me, for Sneeko and Andrew Tate, seeing the whole criticism of them both, I've seen it from people who I know, people who know me, and if by some small chance that they're this deep into this video and he say you're a retard, alright, I'm just stopped fucking caring at this. Not as in that way that you may think. I'm just saying I'm tired of just being a bitch, you know. I'm tired of being a bitch. I just want to say what I want to say. I'm just getting my energy back and shit like that. And I need to harness it in a good way, or else I might self-destruct way too early in my fucking life, you know? I wanna be something, I wanna fucking be big and shit like that, you know? That's probably the first time I've ever said that in a genuine way. I wanna be big on this fucking platform. Good reasons, though. But these people are fucking retarded. They say the exact same shit. They say, oh, he's like, he's misogynistic, he's sexist, he's some shit like that, you know. When you probably think that they're all the same person. They're not the same person. They're all different people. But fucking hell, man, they are all fucking predictable. And as Sneeko says, they're bots, or in other words, they're NPCs. And people like to say, that's dehumanizing. Holy shit, that's dehumanizing. And all that stuff. You're right. And it's funny, alright? That actually sounds horrible. But the point of when people say that this guy's an NPC or people are NPCs is not the fact that they're dehumanizing them. It's the fact that they're all into this one type of umbrella, type of groupthink, alright? Dead ass. I'm not even saying this as a meme, like, oh fuck, can I stop saying bimbo words, bimbo filler words and shit like that? Like, some bullshit like that. But we are going closer to what 1984 has said. I read the fucking book. I know what I'm talking about, alright? I know what I'm talking about when I said 1984, the moment that you fucking heard those words. You said, no, bullshit. No. It's some bullshit like that. They changed the definition of fucking definition. They changed the definition of a recession. Fucking, I don't know when, like a few days ago, like a day or so ago, I don't fucking know. But they did that shit, and it's bullshit. There's newspeak, that's, you know, the definition shit. And now there's groupthink. And this all sounds like schizo. That's what most people have said to, like, all the, like, people who has, like, these radical crazy ideas, quote-unquote, radical crazy ideas that most people aren't familiar with. They call them crazy, they call them, like, schizophrenic, they call them, like, oh, they must be a lunatic, they must be, like, we need to get them on their meds, we need to get them on their Ritalin, so they can, you know, sit down, be obedient, be feminine, be all this bullshit. Actually, no, that's, this all sounds nonsense. But you get what I'm saying, most of the people who were called crazy will end up being right in the end. It's just, it had to take them being killed, and maybe a few decades after, or, you know, being dead in mysterious ways, shit like that, you know, to be proven right. Even by then, some people would be like, nah, or some people would be like, nah, this guy's kind of, you know, retarded and all that stuff. That's gonna happen in this century. There's gonna be a lot of times when big balls, public figures are gonna say some probably on the surface crazy shit, but in decades time, people are gonna say, like, damn, he was really a prophet. He was really, you know, like, predicting the future and all that stuff. I think that's all I need to. That's all I need to say. That's all I need to talk about today. And also, I'm gonna do a stream right after this video uploads. I'm not gonna edit in big ways where it makes the rendering way slower. So look out for that stream. All right. Thank you for watching. Have yourselves a good damn one. I'm just here to hold your hand when you die, and to show you around imaginary places. Put many lumps in my bloody stump, and it will have a smile that's a perfect circle. Dying to sleep with a sky at your feet, I'll treat you when you're happy, only then you will find peace. How did you do it? I don't know, I'm okay. Every person I know is a secret story agent, cause I'm accused of lewd conduct. Stole the heart of rape, who prompts that, and I got a woman for my